Have you ever worked on a project which you had to get access to a list of contacts from your mobile device?
Wait a minute!
Let me put it this way. Are you currently working on a project which requires you to get access to a list of contact details from your mobile device? Wait, what am I even saying? You know what? The introduction. In today's video, we are going to walk through, or I'm going to walk you through, how you can get access to a list of contact details from your mobile device and then render them in your React Native application. So for this and more, let's dive into it. Alright, so I've already set up my project, which I'm not going to cover that in this video. I already have a video on that. I'm going to leave the link down below. You can check it out. So once you are done setting up your project, we would need to install a library, okay, which is Expo Contacts. So this library is supposed to help us get access to the contacts on our mobile device, and then we are going to just render them in our React Native application. All right, so all you need to do is copy this command here, okay, and then once you copy the command, you need to open a new terminal. So you can just come here at the top here and then open a new terminal, or you can click on this plus button to open a new terminal for you. So you are going to paste the command that we copied from the documentation, which is npx expo install expo contacts, okay, and then press enter to install the library for you. I'm not going to do that because I've already installed it. And once you are done installing it, you can check it out just to make sure it has installed expo contacts, okay. So this is write it, okay, and then you also need to check inside your app.json. It should add it to your plugins automatically. So if you don't get it here, you have to manually add Expo contacts to your plugins. And once you are done with this, I think we are good to go. And once you are done with all these setup, you need to also set up your Metro bundler. So you have to open a terminal. I've already done that here. So I open a new terminal and then I type npm run start to start my Metro bundler for me. Okay. So you need to do same to start your Metro bundler for you. And once you are done with that, I think we can now scan the QR code with our Expo Goal application on our physical device to proceed. Okay, so I'm just going to scan my QR code. So scan the QR code right there. So this is going to build the application on our physical device for us. Cool, so our application is up and running. So unfortunately, we are not able to see the text properly. I can just come down here and then add some styles to make it nice. Good, so now you can see our text centered properly on our physical device, right? Which says welcome to Don Hub. So it means our application is running, or is up and running, okay? Now we can proceed. So what you are going to do is, let me bring this one back again. Okay, and then let me remove this text right here. And let me uncomment this one. Good. So this is the entry file of our application. Okay, and we have this component, which is contacts manager. So you are going to do all the coding in the contacts manager. All right. So let me navigate into the components. So this is how it looks. Quite simple. We have the view and then we have a text or text elements to display this text for us. Okay, so when I bring a spacebar and save it, let's wait for application to refresh. Good, you can see we now have contacts manager. Good, so I think now we are good to go. Okay, so the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to import the necessary elements and libraries that we require. Okay, so you are going to need use effects and then use state. You're also going to need some elements from React Native, and then the main guy, which is contacts, right? So you are importing everything from Expo contacts, and then we are saving it as contacts. That is the main guy for this application. The next thing we are going to do is define the interface for our contact. Okay, because this is a TypeScript application, you have to define some interface for our states that we are going to use. Okay, and this is how it looks. We have ID, first name, last name, name, phone number, and then emails. And then the phone numbers and then the emails are arrays, okay? And then in here, we also have some width here, which we are getting it from dimensions. So you are basically trying to get the width of our physical device, which is our mobile phone. So any styling that we are going to do on our mobile phone is 90% going to fit on every device that we run our application on. The next thing we are going to do is to import or initialize the states that will be required for the application. So we have contacts, all contacts loading, has permission, and then search query. Okay, so these two basically stores the same thing at the initial load. Okay, just that the all contacts is not going to be mutable, it's not going to change, all right? But contacts is going to change based on the search query that we are going to make. So let's proceed. So over here we have a couple of functions, okay? The first one is check permission function, and the name is quite intuitive. It's basically supposed to check whether the user has granted us permission to have access to the contacts on the physical device, okay? And then the second one is request permission. That one is basically supposed to request permission for us. So first we have to check if the user hasn't granted us, then we will probably request for permission, okay? And then the next one is load contacts. So this function is basically supposed to load contacts for us. And again, we are using the contacts library, okay? So we are using that to get the contact from our mobile device. And then the fields that we are interested in are name, phone numbers, and then emails, right? And then once we get that, we can probably sort them out and then store them in both set all contacts and then set contacts, okay? So with the set all, as I mentioned, we are not going to change anything, but with contacts, we are going to change them based on the search functionality or based on the search that we make, okay? And then, don't worry, we'll talk about the filter soon, okay? And then we also have the filter contacts. So this function is responsible for search functionalities. We are going to pass in the search query, and then in here we are going to filter our contacts by the full name, the phone number, and then the email. And then once we get the filtered contacts, we can now pass them to the set contacts. That is it. We have clear search here, and then we have this function which is get initials, basically supposed to get the initials of the first name and last name, and probably the name as well. And then the first character of them, we kind of change them to uppercase, okay? We also have get avatar color. Basically, we pass in a contact label or contact name, and then we kind of grab a color for it. So now that we know these functions, we will need a use effect to kind of handle the search functionality for us, okay? Since we are going to need search functionality, we will need a use effect which is going to trigger a callback or a function whenever there is updates of this state, okay? So we have the use effect inside it, we just trim it, and then if the search is empty, we just pass in the all contacts to set contacts, okay? But then if the query is not empty, then we pass the query to our filter contact to filter the contact for us, basically. Right, now let me save that, and as you can see, our application still looks good. The next thing we are going to do is probably bring in the styles that we are going to require for this application or this project. And don't worry, I got you covered. I'm going to leave a link to the source code down below so that you can get access to the styles and everything, okay? And save that. Now the next thing is we are going to add a couple of functions, okay? Great. So we have two additional functions, which is render contacts and also show contact details. So with the render contact, what is basically supposed to do is give us a component in a card form, okay? So like where I'm pointing the arrow to right now, you see this particular card, this is what this component is returning, okay? So you are going to get this component and then we are going to map it with the contact, okay? And this function is supposed to give us an alert, okay? Whenever we click on or we trigger this function, it's supposed to give us a pop-up or an alert which displays the contact details, basically. So I think we are good with that. All right, so the whole idea for this project is once the screen loads for the first time, okay, you will need to check whether the user has access or permission to get access to these contacts. Okay, if the user don't have access to the contact, you probably show some kind of screen for the user to request for permission. Okay, so what we have to do now is probably add another use effect, okay, to call this check permission. So I'm just going to come up here and then implement or initialize a new use effect. In here, I'm just going to bring this, so we call it once, okay, and then we call the check request function. Great, let's store that or let's save that. So what is going to happen is it's going to call this check function, okay, and then it's going to check once the status is granted, it's going to load the contacts for us. If the status is not granted, basically going to leave it, which means it's going to leave the has permission as false. Okay, once the has permission is false, we would want to show some kind of screen, okay, with some button for the user to be able to click on it to grant permission. So here we now have to pass in some or add some codes here. So we have has permission, so we are checking if the has permission is not true, then we kind of return this component. Okay, so with this component we basically have some styles and then some text here which says we need permission to access your contacts to display them in the application. Okay, and then down here we have the button to click on it, and once you click on the button we trigger this function, which is request permission function. Okay, so now let's save this. Great, and as you can see on my physical device we are now getting this nine screen. Okay, so now when we click on the grant permission, we are going to get a pop-up notification or a pop-up which says we should allow ExpoGo to have access to our contacts. So I'm going to click on that, and now we are now getting this as the return component again, right? So now it means the user has permitted us to get access to the contact, so we can proceed. Now let's move on to the next stage of the application. Hopefully you are getting to the interesting part of the application. Okay, so I've included a new section which is the header. So the header basically shows the title, okay, and then shows the number of contacts that we have in the system. The next one I'm going to add is probably the search bar, and then this is how the search bar looks. So on my physical device, very nice search bar. So we have the text input which takes in the search query state, and then we use the or set search query to update the search query, right? And then in here we dynamically render this icon, which is the cancel icon. Okay, so once you start typing in there it pops up, and once you click on it, it kind of clear our contacts for us, right? Or clear our search query for us. Now we are going to proceed to the refresh button. So this is how the refresh button looks. Okay, so the refresh button is basically a button that when you click on it, it calls the load contacts again. Okay, and depending on the loading state we kind of render different things or different text. Now the main guy is in here. Okay, the guy who is going to be responsible for displaying our list for us. So the element responsible for that is called flat list. Okay, so the flat list basically takes in a contact or a data, which is contact. Okay, and it takes in an item. So we say, hey, what am I supposed to render? Okay, so in this case we say contacts, and then it asks again, what component should I render these contacts in? So we provide the render contact component. Okay, and then it asks, I need to identify each of the data or each of the contacts, how should I identify them? So here we provide the extract key, which is a unique key for the contact, and in this case we are going to use the ID as the unit key, okay, or the unique key. And then we pass in some styles here, and then we have this vertical scroll indicator, which I don't know if you've noticed whenever you're scrolling through an application, right, this kind of small or rectangular bar here that scrolls up when we are scrolling up and then comes down when you are scrolling down is the indicator. Okay, in this time around we don't want to show it, so we pass false here. And then we have item separator. It's basically a component or a section where we use to separate the contact components. Okay, so here we just pass in a style here. Okay, and then we have this list empty component. So what should I show if the contact is empty? It means if the contact returns an empty array like this, what should I show? In this case, we are passing in this component, or we are creating this component here. So the component basically dynamically renders some text depending on the loading state and then the search query. Okay, so here you can see we say please wait while we are loading your contact. We can also get no contact match when we search, all right, and then we can get tapped to reload your contacts. Okay, so now I'm going to save, oops, okay, let me change this one back to contact and then probably save it. Great, so let me bring down, or let me hide my keyboard. Okay, and now you can see we are able to display all our contacts in here. Okay, and once we click on one, we get this pop-up, which is right here. Where is it? This one, show contact details, right? And it shows it perfectly for us. So now we are able to kind of grab our contact details from our mobile device and then render them in our application. Okay, now the next thing, on the last thing I would like us to look into, is this filter that I spoke to you, or I just asked you to wait, right? So some contacts, once you delete them some way somehow, it's only the phone numbers or the phone numbers that gets deleted. Okay, the names and then other informations might still be on the physical device or on your mobile device. Okay, so we have to probably add a filter to filter them out, because clearly when you check on a mobile device or on my mobile device, I have some contacts here that don't have the contact displaying on the card, right? Which is not great. So we can just bring this one back and then save our file. Great. So now once we save our file, you could see that now it has filtered out some of the contacts. Initially we had, I think, 2630 contacts, right? But then now it has trimmed it down to, I think, 656 contacts. Okay, so I think we can click on refresh. You can see we get different. You can search for contacts. So let me search for dummy contacts right here. Okay, my folder. Great. If you search for something and we don't find it, you see we are getting this nice empty component right there. Okay, I can search for my folder and I get this contact here. Once I click on it, clearly you can see we are displaying the information right here. Okay, yeah, so I think that is it. And let me roll back, let me remove the filter and let's see again. Great. So as you can see, without a filter we have 2630 contacts, but once we introduce the filter, you're able to reduce it down to 656. Yeah, so I think that is it. This is how you can basically implement your contacts in your React Native application, right? So this is for Expo applications or React Native Expo, okay? But if you are using Bare React Native, you can check this code out, okay? I've named it Native Code. It basically goes through or follow the same format. As you can see here, we have the contacts, we have the use effect, our check functions, right? Our request function and load contact, okay? It follows the same pattern, just that this time around, the library that is going to be in charge is, or is going to recall, is React Native Contacts, okay? So this is the library, and I think we have it right here. Good. So in this case, if you are not using React Native Expo, but then you are using Bare React Native, then you can probably go with this code. You can just check out the source code and then grab it. You can also go to their documentation. I'm going to leave the link down below. You can come here and also read about it, okay? I think this is the end of the video. If you are newcomer here, or you are new to this channel, kindly click on the subscribe button, turn on your notification so that you don't miss any of our content, okay? But if you are not a new, or if the channel is not new to you, but for some reason you haven't subscribed to our channel, kindly subscribe to the channel, click on the subscribe button, like the video, turn on notifications so that any contacts or any content that we are going to drop. So any content that we are going to drop, you are going to be the first person to receive it, okay? And thank you guys for watching. See you next one. Happy coding.